It's time to use my planner pages, and for this month in February, I want to decorate these two pages. Here, my monthly on two spreads, and also my weekly. And I have a couple of things already out. This one looks like it's been through, a rough little journey, but this is actually some really cool washi tape that I purchased, I think, off of Etsy, I believe, a while ago. It's my first time using it, but it has this lovely little landscape design. And then I have scraps of my papers that I recently created, some washi tape that I thought went well with the papers. And then, of course, planner stickers, regular cute little stickers that my sister actually gifted me. She's into those cute little Korean stickers. I purchased some for myself, some plant ones. And I also really enjoy using stamps in my planner. This is a really cute vintage one that I have. And then this is probably one of my favorite stamp sets ever. I think I purchased it from Tuesday Morning. I don't remember who made it or what company, but I like it because of the little borders. And I use this in my bullet journal all the time. And then of course, some scissors and your adhesive. The best part about having a traveler's notebook is that you can also keep your planner or decorative things in your notebook in like these little PVC folders or in a folder that you make. This is the one that we made together, and so I'm going to be definitely using the scraps of papers and ephemera that I have in my folder, as well as the washi tape samples, and I think in here my little postage stamps, and then some other little treasures. So I have everything that I need in one place, which is what I love, especially if I'm using my planner. And I'm also going to be using my bullet journal in conjunction with this, so I don't need to go in full in-depth detail. If I want to, I can. I have all the space to. But we'll see how I end up decorating and using these pages. Here's the trust. Do you hear that bird? I don't know why, but I think that's hilarious. Okay, I bet the bird is excited about the bullet journal. I'm still using my bullet journal, so I'm going to be using my traveler's notebook planner as well as my bullet journal, and I can make a separate video showing you how you can use two planners or journals at the same time. So I'll definitely be sharing that in another video, but I have everything that I need, so let me go ahead and start planning in my traveler's notebook. The pre-decorating is done. I can start using my markers and my pens that I keep in my little pencil pouch. And I will fill in the monthly, the weekly, the to-dos, and I'll show you how my pages look like when they're finished. I have just finished decorating and filling in the month, the weeks, the to-do. So when you first look into my planner, there's a to-do page, and it's just what I have to do this month. I decorated it with the washi tape on the bottom, which I absolutely adored. I had a little oopsies in the beginning, but I still worked with it, and I ended up really enjoying it, and I didn't want to cover up the sentiments or the florals that are a part of the planner digital, so I just kind of cut around the washi tape, just making it work for me. The cute little deer. This is part of the California Dreaming paper kits and washi. I've been enjoying using markers as well as just a normal black pen for my page spreads. So this is a look at my monthly for February. I have the first part of the month pretty much planned out, and then the rest needs to be planned out as I go. I'm not that big of a future planner, so this is as much as I will do. And then I do have my like important little things to do, and I've decorated it with washi, with paper. Stickers, I did some stamping, but it ended up not looking as good as I wanted to. But now I really enjoy it, how there's very bright colors, but there's also this muted tone. Next to my little Bodhi bird, I always love including a little quote next to the little bird, as if you're tweeting something special. I really enjoy using paper and covering up the full little date square for special days that I need to do something. I don't need to write it down. My brain immediately knows what that little paper means, as well as the little stickers, like this day I'm going to go furniture shopping. So it's fun to sometimes not write down everything that you need to plan, but instead use icons in your washi and your paper to let you know what you have to do or remind you of what you need to get done during the month. And then the next page, it's notes and then the to-do. This is the to-do for next month, which is going to be March. For the notes page, I just decorated with paper and washi. I will pretty much just fill this out as I go throughout the month. I like to treat my notes pages as like extra paper in case I need to get anything written down. And then for my next insert, this is my weekly, and then also where I put my goals and other little note spots. For the goals of the month, I decided to color in the little icon with some markers, and I just put here the main things that I need to get done this month. And then for my weekly page, this is the first week of February. I will decorate the next week in a couple of days, but this is an example of how I'm going to be using my weekly pages. I like to add, just like with my month, covering up one part of the week with paper using little scraps of paper. These are from the California Dreaming paper kit. For the majority of my weekly pages as well as monthly pages, you'll notice that I use pretty much the same tips and the same things. Paper to cover up certain special days. I like using markers instead of just a typical black pen to highlight certain things. And using my scraps, stickers, and washi tape. Since I'm always purchasing new stickers and washi, I might as well use it in my planner. So that is how my planner is looking like in my traveler's notebook. I had so much fun decorating it. I have still so many weeks to go, and I will start decorating the month of March pretty soon. So that is a little look into how I use my traveler's notebook planner. You can find the planner in my Etsy shop, as well as the papers that I made for the insert covers. But if you're wanting to create a traveler's notebook planner for yourself or start using one, just start with a blank template that you can find on Google to see if this size and this style would work for you. I have to say, I'm pretty much in love with the space that I have in the traveler's notebook. It's a lot bigger than my old planner, and it's a lot more in detail than my bullet journal. Who knew planning could be so fun? If you're someone that doesn't like this much color, there's also a black and white version available in the shop. As I know, too much color can sometimes be overwhelming, but for me, right now, I want all the color, as that's what's been inspiring me lately. You have both your journal and your planner all in one place, in your trusty, handy-dandy traveler's notebook.